Today I'm going to teach you how to do videos that entertain and engage. Now, I've run a lot of video ads for my business, and I will say it doesn't matter if it's candid or professional. We track the analytics and it's all the same. What matters is the content and if it's engaging enough. The reason why I want to tell you that is because I think we can get too much in our heads and think, oh my God, well, I don't know how to do videos. I don't have a videographer. I can't afford that right now. And I'm telling you, videos sell no matter if it's candid and it's done by your iPhone or if you actually hire a videographer. I personally like to do both. So there's some videos where I will have it be super candid, and I think that speaks to a younger audience. But then I also do polished videos because I like it. I like variety, but I also think someone who is more professional might want that or expect that from me. And so I do a combination of both, but regardless of whether or not you do candid or more polished videos, there are gonna be a few steps that you're gonna need to take in order to make sure that all your videos are engaging. I'm gonna give you some tips today on how to really begin your video so that it grabs the viewer's attention right away. Now, when people are scrolling through, you know, their internet and their apps, you really only have the first 2 seconds to get their attention. And so I'm gonna teach you a couple of ways of how to enter in your video so that it is entertaining. So first things first. So a couple of ways that you can enter in on screen is pop in on screen and introduce yourself, or you could pop up. I mean, those are some of the best ads that we've ever done, is literally pop in on screen. There's another way where you can take the camera and have it walk with you. And you can just be like, hey guys, about to walk into the studio, or hey, my name's Jane, on my way to work. Another way you can make your video more engaging is simply by switching up the angle. You can also make sure that your background is really interesting to enter in on screen. So I'm at my studio right now. You're used to seeing this background, but if I wanted to switch it up, maybe I would go outside, make sure I was, you know, in beautiful scenery with the Red Mountains of Arizona or something to that effect. And so what you put out in your video is also gonna be portrayed to the viewer. So for example, if I walked on screen right now and I was like, hey guys, my name's Jade Hernandez and I'm a camouflage tattoo artist here in Arizona. Versus, hey guys, my name is Jade Hernandez and I'm a camouflage tattoo artist here in beautiful Arizona. Which one is more entertaining? It's gonna be example two, right? It's because of my energy. Now, personally, I have a very low, soft voice. And so when I'm doing videos, I always make sure to like over exaggerate and over emphasize my voice, and I even try and project it as much as I can, because that energy is what's going to be transferable. That's what's going to be engaging, entertaining, than for me to be like, hey everyone, my name's Jade. Now when you meet me in person, I speak a lot less loud, but for videos, when I'm really trying to like be upbeat and inspiring, I always make sure I up the ante. And it's gonna feel funny, you're gonna feel off, but I promise you, those videos are gonna sell, and it doesn't look fake. Those videos are gonna look very natural, they're gonna look very engaging, and so you wanna be sure to push past your comfort zone and really make sure that you project your voice, that you're hyped up, maybe you're standing to really get that energy flowing, because that's what's gonna engage your viewer. Another way to transfer energy is by making sure that your video has music in the background. Not just any type of music. You want music that's gonna be upbeat, motivating, and some of those places where you can get audio that you can have copyrights use of is through Audio Jungle or
Artlist.
I'll be sure to put those links down below in the video. And literally, when you go to Audio Jungle, because I'm familiar with that, is they give you an option to pick the emotion that you want your viewer to feel. And then they'll have cinematic music in the background, they'll have motivating music, something super upbeat, something like more tropics on the vacation. You can also do something that's really hyped up in the club, or something really mellow to be super over dramatic on whatever the content piece that you're creating. And so those are all things that you can use to help you transfer energy to your viewer. The other thing you can use in your video is props. So sometimes I'll use a whiteboard or something to over exaggerate a concept. So for example, I'm a stretch mark camouflage tattoo artist. When women go to the beach, oftentimes they're gonna be more insecure or self-conscious about their stretch marks. And so I might do a video where, hey, this summer, are you gonna be wearing this? And I would make sure that this bathing suit is almost like a muumuu versus this. you know, and I would make sure that this was like a tinier bikini. So when you use props, you can use it to overemphasize an idea and over exaggerate. Again, it's a little bit of humor, but it's engaging. It makes the viewer stop. In this video, I use a small whiteboard and I literally throw it. I chuck it out as part of my video. And again, it's just the engagement. It's the sound of me throwing something. It gets the viewer caught off guard. And so those are how you can use props to make your videos more engaging. Another example would be a brow artist. Brow artists are always selling, you know, the ease and efficiency of having permanent eyebrows rather than having to draw it on to yourself every morning. And so for a video like that, I would have a big ass clock in the video to over exaggerate the time you would spend wasting drawing your eyebrows versus getting it permanently done by my business.